Let me go to the Ugandan capital, Kampala, and talk to my friend, Dr. Jotham Musinguzi. Dr. Jotham Musinguzi, are you there?
Yes, I'm there, Shaka.
What would you say advantages, for example, of having this population explosion, and what are the disadvantages in as far as Africa is concerned, the continent, of course, that you have monitored and worked with very, very closely?
Potentially, a population which is growing is obviously good and welcome. If it is moving, if it is growing at a manageable rate, and what that would mean is that when your population is growing and you have more young people, you have a relative large bulge of young people. These are young people that if they receive good education, and here good education also means they get good skills, and which are relevant, and they also have good opportunities for employment. Then they earn some money, and they, if they make savings, then they can invest in the economy, and they can therefore be potentially the engine for growth for that particular country. So a growing group of young people with those type of described that way would be an asset, a great asset to a country, and that is what everybody aspires to, and that is what demographers have called the demographic dividend, that you have these people who can be an engine of growth, and that means also that relatively there are less older people and lesser children in that population. So that would be very good. But that is not really the situation in a lot of the African countries currently, and the population is growing very rapidly. If you look at some of the countries in the region, growing at 3.2%, 3.1%. That is per annum. That is a relatively high growth of population, and it is not matched by provision of the necessary infrastructure, the food, the availability of the resources that they need in order to be taken as to become a dividend indeed for the country. So Africa has a challenge along the line.
What about the issue of family planning, Jotham? How does it resonate with people? I'm sure in your capacity as a doctor and as somebody obviously that has been engaged in population, situations, you must have been pushing the idea of family planning. Does it resonate with people on the ground?
Absolutely. Family planning is increasingly resonating well with the people. It is true that, as you know, in Africa, we still have people who are not very literate. Illiterate levels still prevail. But also, you know, when you don't have good education in all over the country, and you also still have pockets of poverty, and we say saying pockets is a modest way of putting it. Quite in some countries, widespread the poverty. In some areas, it is very pathetic. And then when you look at some of the cultural issues as well in the African continent, these type of issues continue to constrain family planning. But at the same time, we see increasingly there is what we term as unmet need, that couples and women express themselves that they would wish to use family planning, but they either don't have access because they cannot afford, or it is not easily available to them. And so we still have these challenges. But women in Africa themselves are saying we would like to use family planning either to limit or to stop having children. But unfortunately, a number of them do not have access. So accessibility of good quality family planning remains an issue. Where family planning exists, it is mainly in the urban centers. And if you take some of the countries in Africa, especially sub-Saharan Africa, you'll find that majority of them, Uganda's population is 85% rural. And if their services are going to be mainly in urban centers, obviously you can see issues of inaccessibility. So the family planning will continue to be a very important aspect of the population growing, but we also need to know that at the moment it's not as accessible, and so measures need to be put in place to make sure that women who voluntarily want to use family planning have access to quality family planning that is voluntary, and I think that will help them not only in terms of economics at the individual level, but also in terms of health benefits to them as women, to their children, and to their families. And I think that is an important concept.